So that Dorado I saw yesterday has really inspired me. I think I'm going to do something almost European with it.
Okay.
Maybe bacalao, but I'm not sure. So I might hedge and just buy the basic ingredients and then let's see what we can do with it in the kitchen.
My foraging experience last night was good. This is going to be the first time I'm going to be cooking with snails.
Right.
And I've never handled them. I spoke to the lady yesterday. I'm going to do my best.
Now this is exciting. Cooking with things we've never cooked with before.
You have that feeling. You have
that it's going to be good.
Yeah.
Yeah, so hopefully it will be.
It will be.
Meron ba kayong sili?
Ate, ito yung parang kamote.
Yung bawang ninyo, magkano?
Tamis to.
Tatlo lang siguro.
Magkano to?
Sobrang fresh yung onions ninyo.
Wala kayong tindang gata.
So, it's pretty expensive, actually, the dried Dorado. But I'm sure the flavor is really, really good.
Ito yung bakay.
Okay, done! So we're here at Fundacion Pasita, where they've been kind enough to let us take over the kitchen for a few hours to create dishes based on the ingredients we found here in Batanes. The one that I talked about yesterday and met the people who make it is the dried Dorado, which they call arayu locally. And to me, this is really very, very similar to salt cod or bacalao, what they call in Northern Europe. And it really goes back thousands of years where they're trying to preserve protein for the rest of the season when it isn't so easy to catch fish or to have any kind of meat. So the inspiration was to take a very local ingredient and try to apply it to a very sort of international dish. The ingredients for that are the terrific garlic which they grow here. And then these fantastic red onions, which were fresh in the market yesterday. These terrific tomatoes, which I actually saw the garden in which they were being grown. And then some potatoes, but you could also use the local sweet potato if you wanted to bring some sweetness to it.
So yesterday I went out to go foraging for the very first time. So these are our snails. After an hour of foraging, we were able to catch about 30 to 40. So my take on the dish, I will make a gata kamote mash to go with the marida dish. You know, I respect their authentic recipe. So I'm not really gonna tweak it per se, but I will play with the condiments or the sauces of the dish.
So my approach here is I don't want to touch the traditional dish, but I'll just put new things around it.
We only have about 2 hours before our guests arrive, so we better step on the gas if we're to get these two takes on Batanes staples done in time. So a good tip for home cooks is really how to peel lots of garlic, which can be a bit tedious. So take quite a bit of the garlic that you like, and maybe just to make it a little easier, loosen it up by cutting the tops, and get two bowls, stainless steel bowls or glass bowls, throw them in there. And then and let's see. Boy, this is really tough garlic. You see that a lot of the garlic is already starting to loosen up. So that's just like a little trick for you at home if you want to peel garlic faster.
And speaking of faster, you gotta, you know, have the right equipment or right tools so that you're most effective. I think this is a strong knife. This is a strong knife, so I'm gonna try this. This is sort of like my favorite knife, so. I'm just gonna use this there. It's just easier.
So we're just gonna take the pieces of dried Dorado up and then I'll flake it. One step I'm not going to have so easy is actually shredding the Dorado pieces, which turn out to be harder than I expected. Boy, shredding this fish is not so easy.
Oh, Yeah. It's tedious, no?
Yeah. It's good though. It's good.
Is it cooked?
Yeah. Super salty, probably.
Wow. That's right. That's good flavor.
Yeah. Mm.
That's like good kind of saltiness.
You have to make sure there are no bones left, because if one of those fishermen coming to taste the dish find a bone, I'm sure they're not going to be too amused.
Half an hour into our preps, probably taking advantage of the fact that Joel and I were preoccupied with all the slicing and dicing and mashing and shredding, I noticed some of the marida were making a run for it.
So when this happens, so just don't be afraid, just, they're like little sponges in your shower. So just take them, just remove them. Don't get freaked out, it's fine.
After all the prep work, it's time to fire up the stove and get some real cooking going. So into a pan, we put some olive oil. And then those nice red onions that we chopped earlier. And if you're wondering, in all those cooking shows where they do just that, they put the oil and they put the onions straight, you have to preheat the pan and turn off the pan so it looks like you're ready to go. That's just one of those ridiculous tricks that we have up our sleeve.
Now, my turn.
Get ready to have a hot sauna. Sorry, guys, but...
Wow, they go straight back into their shell.
Oh, here's... This one doesn't want to go.
No!
When you're enjoying cooking in the kitchen this much, time sure flies. And I have to say, the deadline kind of slipped my mind.
Last 35 minutes.
And when I was reminded of it, I realized I still had a long way to go.
You know, I'm pretty confident in my abilities in the kitchen. Till... I burnt the garlic. Then that's when the stress kicked in.
Sige lang.
Good thing the excellent chefs at Fundacion Pasita were kind enough to lend a hand. And the show, or I mean the cooking, must go on. Especially since I heard our guests are already on their way.
It's a mad, mad rush to get everything done on time and get our plates out to the guests.
Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. It is our honor to cook for you guys. Alam ko gutom na kayo.
So for my dish, I use all the ingredients the hostaliero said were the basics of their marida dish. Ube, kamote, and marida. And added my personal experiences to it.
Ito naman ay yung gubat na inakyat namin. Parang siyang stairs to the mountain.
Like climbing Mount Iraya last night to forage for marida.
These breadsticks is because daming alon dito.
The waters here in Batanes are so tempting for surfers like me, but are too rocky or corally to do so.
JP has this incredible story, which we continue now to the sea. Itong Dorado or Arayuna galing dito. The idea is to have a salty, tomatoey, sour dish na katulad ng sarsado, pero may konting kaibahan sa preparation. And it's topped with fried arayu. So, along with the other dishes from Fundacion Pasita, this is possibly one of the best spreads that I've seen in recent memory. So please, let's eat.
Hello.
Hello, Nanay.
Kain.
Kain na.
Better late than never.
Cooking the dish for the first time, you're always apprehensive that it might turn out
inedible, but I was very, very pleasantly surprised with the results. The result was a bacalao that I think had flavor, had presence, had verve, and had local content. It is very nice to see locals appreciating their ingredient in a different dish.
Masarap din. Hindi kagaya nung ginagawa ko kasi ano, nilagyan ko lang ng kamatis pero hindi kagaya nung ginawa niya.
Kung sa akin panlasa eh, sarap. Nakokontrol yung alat niya, nawawala. Hindi katulad nung luto namin dito, kapag nagganyan, nagluto kami ng dorado na yung daing, maiwan yung alat niya na nalalasahan. Hindi ko pa na detalye lahat yung mga ano niya, mga ingredients niya, pero makuha namin yung mga ingredients niya, kaya na namin gawin yun.
Now you're looking at their eyes, you're looking at their movements, you're looking at their food body language, and then when you see that little nod, then I'm like, okay, guess they like it. So that was pretty cool too. And you know, it's such a nice feeling to cook a dish that they've been doing forever.
Kami nabusog. Talagang kung tustusin, baka pwede namin maubos yan.
Nasarapan ako. May pagkaiba siya doon sa traditional na luto. Masarap yung flavor niya, yung aroma, at saka linagyan pa doon ng laurel, kaya itatry namin. Kasi masarap din eh. Di, at least naman, nagkaroon kami ng dagdag kaalaman na recipe sa kanya. Kaya kong gayahin yan, tutang tatandaan ko.
So the view is not to be believed.
Grabe. Is this real?
Yeah.
You get the mountains and the waves.
Possibly one of the best views I've seen in a long time.
Yeah.
So it's one of the best destinations we've been to, and oddly no market, but terrific anyway.
Like what you said earlier, the entire place is the market.
Yeah.
It's good that they're far away from everything or from everyone.
I think that's helped protect a lot of the tradition and a lot of the culture.
Mm.
And I think it really shows through in the food.
Right.
Everyone thinks remote locations have so few ingredients and so little to work with. I feel like it's so liberating to have just a few ingredients, but they're of such superb quality.
Right. And, I mean, they have it in front of them. Yeah. Or they have it up in the mountain. So, you know, you can really taste the actual flavor. You know, when you eat a dorado dish, you could really taste the dorado. It's not masked by the seasonings or whatnot.
It's pure.
It's pure.
I think it's unadulterated, so it shines through. They're very proud of it. And actually, it tastes really good. So in the end, you can have as much culture as you want. But of course, the question is it appealing? Does it taste good? And this stuff tastes good. For me, one of my favorite locations so far. It has that mixture of remoteness and yet high quality ingredients, nice people, phenomenal vistas. There's just so much to see in the Philippines, and this has to be one of the ones that are at the top of the list. Well, next trip coming up soon.
All right, it better be like this too.
Yeah, hope so.